And particle size, when we talk about particle, we quite often have to talk about size, particle size. For so-called equidimensional particles, equidimensional, which means you look at it from different angle, different direction, they are roughly the same dimension, same length, sphere or cube, you just use the characteristic size, diameter or edge length. Simple? Okay. But for irregular shaped particles, then how do you define size? It becomes tricky, but roughly, depending on the way it's measured, we can define volume diameter, which is diameter of a sphere that has the equivalent volume, or surface area, surface diameter. Diameter of a sphere have the same total surface area, or Stokes diameter. Diameter of a sphere that has the same sedimentation. Within a liquid, how fast does it drop from the suspension to the bottom? Sedimentation. Okay, right. And sieve diameter. What's the diameter that would go through certain mesh, certain sieve? Okay, we just quickly go through them. And then particle size distribution. Real powders have a range of sizes. Very rare we have uniform, exactly the same size. They always have a size distribution, particle size distribution, or PSD, presented in different form. Sometimes we use frequency diagram. Different size, okay, you count. For between certain size range, how many? You get a histogram, so-called frequency histogram. And then from frequency histogram, you can have so-called relative frequency histogram. The total bar height add up to what? To one, okay. I have this many, but then the total, I get the total number, then I can have so-called relative frequency histogram. Okay. Then we can have so-called cumulative frequency histogram, which means up to certain size, I have 100%. Whatever is smaller than certain size, I give it a percentage. Cumulative frequency histogram. And then the other one called a distribution function, which means the total area underneath the curve would be 100% or 1. That's the typical so-called distribution function. That, okay, the function here would be dq would be the local number divided by the incremental distance. Okay, let's stop here. Okay, after we talk about the particle size, we're going to talk quickly about something, particle size distribution, some of the features, normal distribution, what you learn in probability, mathematics, normal distribution. Okay, and limitation. What's the limitation with normal distribution? It's symmetric. Completely symmetric, which means there would be also finite fraction with what? Negative side. From mathematically point of view, that's if it's more normal distribution, that something goes towards negative, but that has no physical meaning for practical material. Okay, no upper size limit. It has to go to infinity, but again, it has no practical meaning. Log normal distribution, similar. Okay, except inside x, you have natural log of x. Similarly, no upper size limit. Mm-hmm. Of course, now is everything positive, at least. Okay, and other distribution, empirical distribution,